Hello friends, welcome to H2Zone Solution and Production. In this tutorial we will discuss about this project, which is Sensor Monitor API application. It is using Symfony 5 and also using RESTful API. Also we are using MySQL, and after the end of this project we are using PHP unit test. But in this tutorial we are assuming that you are already familiar with Symfony 5, how Symfony 5 works. The main focus of this demo is we will show you that how we can make API and we can send request on any URL and get response. For the test purpose we are making a test case for the IoT sensor, which will send the any temperature or any carbon dioxide levels, and it will monitor the temperature, and if we will send request with respect to their sensor temperature, it will response different status to us. So for the testing purpose we make different cases, like these are four cases which we will test in this demo, and after that we will doing the test cases in this demo. Also we will make different entities, and with the help of entity we will run the different Symfony database command, which will make automatically database for us. So if you are not familiar with these basic thing, so you need to subscribe our channel, and looking forward for our upcoming video in which we will explain basic thing about Symfony, how Symfony works, and how Symfony entity frameworks classes can create. Like in this project we have different entities like sensor alert, sensor detail, and sensor measurement. We will show you how these entities make with commands without doing any programming. Like in class we can see that it has lot of code, but we did not write anything manually. We will use different commands which will create these classes for us, and after that when we will use these migration command, it will automatically make database for us. Okay, now let's start the project. For this project I make this folder sensor monitor for our project. So I go to this path, and after that I use this command Symfony new sensor monitor API, which is usable for microservice API. So when we will run this command, and this new folder will automatically create for us, which has everything related to Symfony will download for us. And after that when everything will be done, then we will go to this folder using command prompt, and after that when we will run this command, and Symfony will work for our browser. So let's discuss how these things works in our tutorial. Let's start. First I am starting my Symfony services, which is running on port 8000. And first start the Symfony. You can see that my Symfony environment is ready. So now come to the database. For database purpose I make different classes for this project. Like you can see that in entity I have classes, because I want to make three tables, and using this code first strategy I just made a class which has different columns, or you can say variables, and it will automatically create database for us. Even same for sensor detail and for the sensor measurement. So you can see that I am using MySQL, which don't have any sensor monitor database. First I am using this command to make a database for this project, which will make using these classes and using this migration. First, I am going to create database, and you can see that new database is created, sensor monitor DB, which is empty. So now I am going to run my migration make command. Yes. Now my migration is ready. Now I will execute this migration using this command. And last migration has already some of these tables, so that's why it is showing some warnings. Now check our database, and you can see that all tables are ready, and even it has one migration in this table. And as per as our three entities, it make three tables. We can see the table information like sensor details, sensor measurement, sensor alerts. This is our sensor detail table structure, which have these fields: ID, UUID, MAC ID, IS is active, row insertion date, which will be auto insert date time. And I am considering this sensor as IoT device, so that's why it has a MAC address. You can see that our sensor detail entity, it has same variables and fields like ID, UUID, MAC address is active, and row insertion date. That's why it make this column in our table. Same like for other classes, like sensor measurement has some variables which made in this table: sensor measurement, sensor detail ID, carbon dioxide level reading date time, and row insertion date time. And it has the foreign key relation with sensor detail ID, which I already manage in my sensor measurement entity class. You can see that it has relation, many to one relation with sensor detail table, so that's why it make a relation with sensor detail table. Same for last sensor alert table, it also has a sensor detail ID foreign key. So I will put a sensor detail ID in sensor alerts and sensor measurement. And now point is why I made two tables: sensor measurement and sensor alerts. Sensor measurement will only log all carbon dioxide level record in this table. But if anything will be like in alert mode, that like for this task, we are saying that if our carbon dioxide level will be greater than 2000, then the mode will be alert. So that's why I make a alert table where all the history will be saved. Now let's test our API. For the API, I make this sensor detail controller, where I have defined admin/sensor root, so that a user can easily add any new sensor or any IoT device, which will be sent CO level for adding sensor. I am going to this link. This is a page where we can add our sensors, which will be inserted in sensor detail table. Let's add some sensor. Like I already testing for these two sensors, so I am using same information. Our one sensor is added in our sensor detail table. You can see that. After that, I am going to adding another sensor. Our two sensors are added in our database. Now we are considering that we have two sensors or IoT devices which has different MACs. So our system will automatically our sensor will automatically send data in this table using our API. For API, I made a measurement controller. This measurement controller had different functions, like for the insertion I am using this post method request, and this is the URL which will use to insert data into the sensor measurement database table. Okay, first go to this requirement section and see the first problem. This is our first problem or task in which we are going to add this data and send on this request. For this purpose, I am going to open Postman. For time saving, I already make a request. This is a request, and I am going to send its method as post because I already mentioned that it should be a post method, and it will add sensor measurement. And for the data, I already defined the CO level and the time for this reading. Okay, first I am going to make it as in cool version. The temperature is going good. I'm going to send the request. Okay, got it. I am using a wrong URL. I should use this URL. I am using this measurement after sensors. And now I am going to send it. Now you can see that one measurement collected for our database, and we can consider it that it will automatically send via our any sensor or IoT device in our database after some seconds. And you can see that our data is inserted as CO level 1171. Now test that what is the level or intensity of our sensor status. This is a different status, like OK1 alerts. So let's test it. For this purpose, I make this URL and we are going to open it, and it will check the latest record related to this UID. No point in what is how this UID get information. It will send data to this controller, and this controller will get the ID using this table sensor detail. It has UID, and it will send this ID to and insert this two into measurement table, because it is our foreign key. That's why we insert two instead of UID, and it is showing okay because our last sensor detail has a level less than 2000 as per this requirement. That if measurement is less than 200, then the status will be okay. So that's why it is sending okay. Now we are going to send another request, like 1271, and it is same okay because less than 2000. Now we are going to exceed from our limit 2271 and setting time like as. Now check the status, which is as 1, because as per as this requirement that if we get greater than 2000 more than 3 consecutive values, then we will show the alert message. In this case we have, it has only one value which is greater than 2000, so we are considering it as 1. If we will have more than or equal to 3 latest values which has more than 2k or 2000, so we will show the warning as alert. For this purpose I am going to insert more values like 23, and it is also showing 1 because it has only 2 values which is greater than 2000. Now we are going to exceed its limit and convert into alert, because now database has 3 values, database has 3 values which is exceeded from 2k or 2000, so that's why now warning will be alert, and even it will log our alerts in alert table. It is showing that we get alert message in this time, and now it will again cool down after we getting less than 2000 value. Like for testing purpose I am again sending one new value as 28 and the time is 14:15. Now send it again. Our last values are more than 2k. It will check related to latest time for checking this 3 values condition. So that's why it will again show alert. And now we are going to cool down the sensor. Like we are going to send 1871. Which will meet this criteria. If we will again come any value which is less than 2k, then our value will be moved to OK. We are going to send it again, and let's see, time date is 18 and time is 18:18. Send again. And now check the status, and now it goes to OK, because now our value is less than, our latest value is less than 2000, which is 8171. So it will also log in our alert sensor alert table, and enter last 3 values which is exceeding from 2k. We can also make a new table and make a foreign key for this purpose. So as a time constraint, that's why I am using comma separator. Otherwise most of the time I make a new table and make a foreign key for this purpose. Okay, now our these cases are tested well. So now move to next problem. Our these two cases are tested. Now we will test our matrices, which will send the latest 30 days record and also average 30 days records. For this purpose I already make URL. This is the URL for matrices. I'm going to open it in browser. It is showing that 00, because our all last reading dates are less than 30 days. It is related to 10th month, which is October. So for this purpose I am going to send some latest values like 2 3 am setting current month. And good thing about this program which I designed, that when the limit is going to cool down like less than 2k, then it will also log the latest time, which is this one, 2020 12 5 18 18. You can see that it is logged in our end time. Start time is the first entry time and the last time is last entry time. Okay, now we have some latest records for this month, so I am going to test it now for matrices. And now you can see that our last 30 days maximum records is 2945 in our last 30 days. We can also check it, 2945. You can see that. And if we will add all these three and divided by 3, and then we will get this result, 2495, which is average in last 30 days records. Now test the last listening alerts API request, which is also has a get request. So I am going to test it on browser using this URL. Sorry, I did not define the route for this purpose. I pause this video and fix this issue. You can see that during the pause video I make a new URL for this API, and you can see that before that it don't have this API URL request path. I check it is with PHP bin console debug root. With this command I see in all my paths for this API project. So now my path is added. Now I test this URL, and now you can see that it is sending same report which we require as per this document or user requirement. And you can see that it is showing start time, end time. It is showing start time, end time, and also giving the measurement. And it is showing the all back history for all our previous days. It is showing using the help of this table sensor alerts, which is showing two records. And we can say that we want to check that how many time our threshold value will be exceeded. In our case we can see that it is exceeded for 2 times. If it will goes many time, then it will show as many time in this JSON response, because it is dynamic. Now our all tasks are done related to this requirements. And now come to code. Let's see, for this admin panel I made this class which is sensor detail, which has different UI like admin sensor, admin new, and also for edit purpose I am using sensor slash id, and also using edit. Sorry, this is for view and this is for edit. And also I am using delete method. And now come to other request. For these requests I made this class which is sensor measurement. In sensor measurement controller we have different URL path, like this path is to checking, this path is going to post data into DB, and it will send data into our database, and also it will check the validation. If validation is not good, then it will send 400 requests. For this purpose, I had also make a test case. Like, let's run this test case. Like, in this test case, if I am going to send any invalid request, like we can test it here that I am going to send any invalid UUID, like send here, and it is going to show invalid UUID value error, and also it will send 400 messages. So I even make a test case, like I am going to test it using this command. It will not only test this case, it will also test these three cases. One case is check that if invalid request, then it will send 400 requests, and after that I am going to set request which is correct UUID, so that will that's why it will send the 2000 requests. So these two cases is a valid. If I will put 200, like first test this test cases, like three cases are passes, if I am going to set this as 200, but it is invalid request and it will send 400 response, so that's why our test case will be false. Like you can see that it is showing false. And our last case is that we can check that our API request, like in current case we are saying that our let message our current status of this UUID is okay or not. We are going to test this, like we can test it that. See it that it is in okay status. We are testing with this test case that it is showing that this UID has current status is okay. That's why it is showing test case as okay message for all these cases. Okay, now come back to SensorMeter controller again, and also I made a this path which will get the result that it is the okay message or not, or it will be a alert or warn message. It will get the latest values from our database. You can see that it is getting the latest record, which is also doing order by descending reading rate time. And if our latest record related to this sensor less than 2000, then it will be show okay record, okay message, otherwise it will show the warn message. And also same for alert, it will check using this function, and also it will check all latest values. If all three latest values is greater than 2000, then it will be show alert message. Otherwise, if value will be less than 2k, then it will be sent false and consider it as a okay or warn message. Okay, and now come to alert message. Alert message for showing the report, and it will get the data from alert table, and also after the getting the data from alert table, it will show in this format. Like you can see that we want to see it in this format, that's why I am doing different processing, and after that I am sending response to this page. And this is our matrices path. In matrix path we are also getting the data from the measurement table, and from the measurement table we are setting two values, which is maximum coal level within last 30 days, and same for average. We are using this variable which is checking 30 days back and also calculating average, and our both variables are ready, and we are going to just set it for our response, which is showing this page. Okay, now I go through all the processes and tasks, and also I give the demo related to all these tasks. Okay, that's all. I hope you like the tutorial, and now you are able to understand how we can make RESTful API in Symfony 5. If you want to learn more, then subscribe our channel for upcoming video in which we will discuss how we can make a Symfony basic project, and also we will discuss how we can make databases using NT. And for NT classes, we will use different command instead of writing classes manually. So please subscribe our channel for upcoming interesting videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.